Hello and welcome back to the Only Fools Love Horses YouTube channel. In a week that has been in turmoil for horse racing, we've had no Cheltenham. There's been a lack of jumps racing. We may not even see it this week. We are back on your screens. We've got a couple of horses to review from Cork on Sunday. Energumene was back out ahead of his Queen Mother attainment this year, potentially. And then we've got the horse that could be out on the weekend, Ascot and Haydock, but they are subject to inspections throughout the week. I am, of course, joined by the usual suspects, Harry and Lee. We've got a lot of action to go through, gents. We're going to keep it nice and sharp. And the main focus point here, Harry, is that if we've got no racing, at least we're going to put up a horse. We've all got a fancy for Christmas. I know you've got one for the Welsh National, and that'll be good to reveal later on.
Oh, fingers crossed it all goes well. Fingers crossed we get some racing. I'm fed up of seeing Sutherland Wolverhampton on my screens throughout the afternoons. I just want some jumps back.
Hey now. Wolverhampton is lovely, and I won't have a bad word said about it.
No, but it is a problem, but we can't do anything about it. So fingers crossed we get racing on sooner rather than later. But no, it'd be good to get some ante-post fancies out there. We had a good weekend, the Twitter Live. That was quite good.
Yeah, that was really good. Thank you very much for everyone who tuned in. Lee, we've had all these cancelled races. I'm actually a little bit excited for the Christmas period now because these horses who haven't ran this weekend and this week, they're going to be having to take in a Christmas race instead if they want to stay on plan. It's going to be hopefully quite competitive going forward, and hopefully we've got a couple of fancies for the Christmas races.
Yeah, it's been tough because there's not been much juice in the ground, so then trainers don't want to take the risk, but it means there's going to be an action-packed Christmas period. Even your castle was cancelled the other day on the all weather, so it just shows the weather's getting affected. Your castle's due to race over jumps at the weekend. There's got no chance, literally no chance.
Well, we'll see what happens there, but at least we've got the all-weather racing, and as I look on my screens, Tony Carroll's got some runners at Wolverhampton, so we'll see if he can bang a winner in, and I'm going to shout it from the hilltops. We'll quickly review what happened at Cork, gentlemen. I'm not sure we're going to spend too much time on this because I don't think we have too many outlandish opinions, and you know it's already been said about these horses, but Energumene did win the Grade 2 Hilly Way, won it quite comfortably, made a couple of mistakes, but we tend to sort of learn that from him now. Harry, he's done it fairly workmanlike. I know you've put out a sort of jarring comment on Twitter about him and Edward Stone, so are you still happy to stand by that?
Of course, Ash, I live by the sword and I die by the sword. Now, as much as I'm a fan of Edward Stone, I don't think he'd be able to live with Energumene, if I'm being completely honest. Listen, he's done nothing wrong to suggest he wouldn't live with Energumene, but I just think he's a different caliber. I mean, you quickly touched on it there. He kind of ploughed through a few of his fences, but that's absolutely fine. I mean, just look at the way he went past the line. It was still a resentment of his old self from last year. So listen, I thought it was a really good performance. I'm really looking forward to seeing him back out. And listen, I can't see him getting beat.
Edward Stone is sat at home and he'll be chewing out.
He won't be on the phone. So it's fine.
Energumene's going to chew up and spit out Edward Stone come March, according to Harry Lee. You are sort of a similar opinion on that?
Yeah, it's just nice to see the horse back out. Done it easy enough. It was kind of egg and spoon racing behind. Although Master Maxi was third there, he's a Grade 1 winner, but they couldn't live with Energumene, and that was it. Party was over. Jumped well on the whole. Like Harry says, there was two maybe if he jumps, but bar that, jump well on the whole, and it's just nice to get the horse back out and kick on the champion chase. I do think he's the winner. The only one, if you look at the race, is Edward Stone, but that Tingle Creek kind of fell apart
Boys, listen, Edward Stone, I'm going to die on my sword here. He's just not going to be anywhere close to an early.
Where's he going to finish, Harry?
He might finish second, but he might be half a furlong behind him. It just doesn't matter.
I think you're giving Edward Stone too much flack here. I think he's actually a very, very nifty horse.
I'm not giving him flack. I just think Energumene is a different beast.
We spent plenty of time there on something that was quite working, like Impervious. She won the Grade 2 Mares Novice Chase on the weekend. That was a really nice performance, Harry. We have to give a shout out to Deck Carroll from Understarters Orders podcast. He talked about this horse on our Saturday Live, saying it could be an Arkle contender, a bit like Riviere de Tell last season, taking in that mare's allowance into the Grade 1 at Cheltenham Festival. I think she's still a fairly decent price for that. Were you impressed enough to maybe consider her as an Arkle contender?
I was. I thought she jumped really well on the whole, and the way she quickened past Dino Blue, who's no mugging behind, was really taken in my opinion. I don't know what you lads thought of it, but I mean, I don't know whether we've already mentioned what price deck tips her up at for the Arkle, but it was the 1-0-0-1. She won't be that price anymore, I can assure you that. But listen, yes, got to improve from that. But the disappointment in that race, Ash, it was Instit. The horse I did actually say is one of my selections for the Mayor's Chase in March. Now, I am 100% sure that was not her performance. Now, I think Paul Townend reported that she was tired passing the line, which is completely understandable. It's her first run back. If she produces any sort of form, she'll be a different horse, believe me. So I think this could be a nice little race, Ash.
Yeah, it could be. I just have, at this early stage, I just have a bit of a question about the form. Like, you mentioned Dino Blue's a nifty animal there. She is, but you take a look back through her form. She beat Rosie's Hollow, who was miles back in this race on Sunday. She beat that horse by 3 lengths in November at Cork. She finished 4 lengths behind Party Central in Novice Hurdle at Punchtown Festival. We watched that race, Harry. Beating 10 lengths by Brandy Love before that, was stuffed in the Cheltenham Mares Novice and won a maiden hurdle quite comfortably. Like, I'd have questions about Dino Blue's form going forward, and it was a very good performance, an RPR of 150 achieved by Impervious Lee. But I take it with a bit of pinch and salt. What do you make of Impervious's run for the connections?
I'm the same with you. I don't know what the form's worth, and I think it was a good run. Between the second last and the last, kind of made up 3 or 4 lengths within a matter of strides, and then through at the last kind of thing and won well at the line. Look, you have to just see what else comes out. I wouldn't be backing one for the Mayor's Chase anyways at this point. I know Deck says Arkle getting allowances and even the Turners, there was big prices thrown about there, but wait and see for me.
You'd arguably say that the Tuesday course would suit her better than the Friday course if you're looking that far ahead for the Cheltenham Festival. But a performance I was definitely taken by compared to Impervious. I was taken by that, but the form was there. But Hiddenvalley Lake, Albert Bartlett contender there, one for Henry de Bromhead earlier on the card. This was really nice, Harry. I don't know what you thought, but I really quite like this performance.
Yeah, it was. The way this horse quickened was really, really impressive for me, especially over that distance as well. Beating no mugs in behind. I think Cool Survivor, Mumbeg Park for Sean Doyle, they really liked that horse. 6-4 favourite on the day. And listen, Rachel and Henry partnership to be forced with. So isn't it really that I think now they're kind of getting going. They've had these kind of types before in the past. Obviously, we've seen the likes of Bob Ollinger. I can't remember the Rob Call horse last year. It was really well. I mean, you got like Journey With Me. There's horses like these that they kind of have the same sort of profiles, but this horse really, really stuck on well. And 3 miles just looked like a minimum in my eyes. And you could argue to see this horse that's easily staying out that distance, especially up the hill.
Yeah, he looks a proper horse, Lee. I kind of agree with Harry on this. Do you concur with those thoughts?
Yeah, I took it at a different angle, as in Henry's horses have been slightly out of form. Obviously, they found something with Aplutard, and I just was waiting for him to really kick in. He had a double there the other day, 2 nice winners, and I know you're going to mention the other horse as well. I thought that both won well, and just nice to see him turn a corner before coming into Christmas for them bigger races.
Yeah, no, definitely. It was a really nice performance there. I'd like to keep the fourth on side. Just in my notes here, let's be clear about it. I thought he looked to be in a little bit of trouble going around the bend for Gavin Cromwell there, but he stuck on well. He's I'd say he's probably the horse to take out the race for me personally. And you mentioned there, Lee, Arctic Bresil won the race beforehand. Same connections. A sprightly character over 2 miles, but quickened up well when asked. Expensive purchase for connections, and he's gone and shown the price tag of why he is that expensive.
Yeah, again, another great performance. actually would have took Mercury out the race in second. I thought he'd close well to the line. I think the two of them will go on to bigger and better things. Look, Rachel threw him into the last and he was away, to be fair, but Mercury definitely want to keep on side of, I would have said.
That's the thing, Harry. Mercury's a really nice horse. There's a lot of people who are talking about this horse for the champion bumper last season, but he didn't end up running. It's potentially really quite strong form there, and he's swept inside quite well.
Listen, I'm going to hate to jump on you here, lads. I don't know whether this might be strong for. I think the winner is a really smart horse. Mercury just didn't do it for me on Sunday, in my eyes. I thought the third horse was getting to the second, if anything, and I thought Ricky Doyle put that horse as much out as he could and just couldn't hold him back anymore. So I think that horse, in if anything, you've got the first and the third. They would be the ones that I take out of this race, especially the third, because if that horse gets a nice handicap mark, that would definitely be exploited. So, listen, on the whole, a really nice performance from Arctic Bresil, I thought. And as Lee mentioned just prior to that, Henry's armour starting to get a little bit of form going, which is really good to see. And as always, if they start hitting form, those horses are proper talent. So, fingers crossed, it's another nice one for them.
Yeah, fingers crossed, definitely. We've flown through that, gentlemen. We don't want to spend too much time because a lot of things have already been said about these horses. But something that hasn't been talked about, obviously the racing on the weekend, will it or won't it go ahead? We're going to keep this preview quite short and just focus on the main race, the long walk that is our main focus, we'll say, over 3 miles, grade one. Champ tops the market after his Newbury success at 15-8 currently for Nicky Henderson. Paisley Park, Emma Lavelle in there at 5-2 was obviously in that grueling finish there. At Newbury, Miranda comes into it as sort of this new hot contender into the field for Paul Nichols. Harry Cobden's already jocked up 7-2. Goshen trying their mark over 3 miles now, 8-1 for this horse. Botox Haas, not so sleepy, and Queensbrook completes the lineup. Harry, I can tell, I can see the twinkle in your eyes. You're going to say Goshen, aren't you? I can tell it.
Do not be silly. It's a Tuesday evening. Do not be silly. It's 6:10. Behave yourself, man. No, right. Sorry, I really analysed this race, and I was trying to get away from Champ. I was trying to do everything I could to find an angle away from him. Now, I'm going to say a few things here, and it shocked me when I did a little bit of analysing. Now, his record in November and December throughout his career reads 1-1-1-1-1. Now, that is interesting to my eye. And now, barring his RSA win, now I know that was spectacular in the way that it was, but you can arguably, I mean, it's made apparent that he's a better horse fresh. He's definitely a better horse this side of Christmas than he is the other side of Christmas. Now, that is 100% my opinion. I don't know whether you lads think of the same, but I think if you're going to catch him right, you could catch him right at Newbury last time. I think you can also probably catch him right this time on Saturday. I hope they go ahead because I think he's got another massive chance. A few of these are stepping into unknown territory. Goshen, not so sleepy. Queensbrook, they're all stepping up and trip. They're all good horses on the day. Goshen is especially a good horse. Queensbrook, I know Ash, you're a fan of her. Not so sleepy. Mm. He's getting on. I think he's 10 now, is he? I think he might lack a little bit of I'm not saying he's not talented, but I think these are really, really smart stayers in their own rights in this field. So, after that record I told you about in November, December, I think it's Champ's to lose. He won the race last year. I think he can win it again this year.
Yeah, no, like I think Champ, I completely agree with you on that Christmas, sort of before Christmas point. Speaking to John Joniel Jr., it's apparent this horse goes well fresh. And he was saying that even after his Newbury run, they can still, because he's had such a long summer off, they can still keep him fresh coming into the long walk on the weekend. So he'll definitely be prime for his race here today on the weekend. Lee, it seems like Champ's quite a warm favourite here. I can see past him. I am going to put up a couple of horses just to mention, but he is quite solid at the top of the market, in my opinion. Would you agree with that?
Yeah, look, I always seem to get the horse wrong, but look, he's won this race before, and this race I think will suit him well. Paisley Park, he'll come home like a train. Miranda, she has to step up, and Goshen, obviously, stepping up the 3 mile. It'll be interesting to see. Obviously, they have Botox Haas in here as well, but I'd love to see Goshen step up the 3 mile. Not so sleepy. is going from a fighting fifth to a 3 mile race, you know, 2 to 3 has to step up again. And same with Queen's Brook. She bombed out the first day of our first run this season and obviously won well the last day, but this is a different kettle of fish. I think Champ, young John Joe, obviously said that he'd still be fresh for this race and that's good enough for me. So Champ all the way.
Yeah, no, like Champ definitely. I'm going to have to mention a couple of horses here, lads. Like, I think there's two, and you're going to hate me on the one that I'm going to say.
There's only seven in the race.
First of all,
mention a couple.
I first of all think it's a really, really good race. Like, sometimes you see in this 3 mile stairs division, you get some lackluster displays. But I think these new horses coming into it inject that excitement into the race. Miranda, I know someone quite well who's in the ownership partnership, is known as Group Horse. They said as soon as she won her last race against Martello Sky and Molly's Ollie's Wishes, Paul Nichols was confident of going to this race. He said they have to go for this race. There's nowhere else they can go with her because she's at that level and they just have to try it. For me, it wouldn't be one I'd be going for personally, but I love it for connections if they'd win. The two horses that stuck out to me really were the two at the end of the market. Queen's Brook, I'll give a small mention for. It's not going to be my main one because you're going to love what I'm going to say later. But Queen's Brook, they really like this horse at Gordon Elliott's.
I dread to think what
they really like this horse at Gordon Elliott's. They told me on the Tuesday of the Cheltenham Festival, they said, yeah, she's going to go really close here in the mare's herd. We'd be surprised if she doesn't win. She got beaten by Maurice Rock. This was the horse that Nicky Henderson was talking about as his probably most exciting horse coming into the race, bar Constitution Hill, coming into the whole Cheltenham Festival. He said, that one horse, you ask him the question, what horse are you most excited for, Nicky? And he said, you know what? Maurice Rock at Cheltenham. He said he's really excited for that horse, and that horse won. Queen's Rock was in second. She's gone and shown it in November at Punchestown this year. She absolutely bolstered up to beat Heaven Help Us. Whether that Heaven Help Us is that good anymore, we don't know, but she's a really nice horse, and she's getting the weight. She's getting 7 pounds. She has to go sort of fairly close in my eyes. But the one I thought here was just screaming out to me. It was just saying back to me, not so sleepy. 14-1, lads. You absolutely love it. Very, very interesting over 3 miles here. The furthest he's tried before was 2.5 in the entry hurdle in 2021. Argument to say that his flat form will have him right at it here over 3 miles because he's been a predominantly 2 miler over the flat. He was third in the Cesarewitch behind the Charles Burns horse. Name escapes me now. The Charles Burns horse that was completely well handicapped. Run for Oscar, thank you very much. Tried to make all to use his stamina there and stayed on well, four legs behind there. He tried to do the same in the 2020 Cesarewitch where he was fourth, I believe. He even looked back at his fighting fifth. I'm convinced the reason why he dead-heated with Epiton was not because of his speed, it was because of his stamina. He comes into the second last going ahead. He jumps the second last. He gets overtaken by both Epiton and Sir Royale. Coming up to the last, they jump it. He's a half a length down and he stays on at the line. Him and Epiton stay on past the line. Sir Royale is back at length behind. So they're staying, both of them staying on. And I think he's just so interesting at this unexposed 3 miles. 18-1, I had written down my notes there. It's actually 14-1. He is a massive price.
He definitely stayed on well the last day. He was closing on Epiton, to be fair.
He's just a quality horse. He's just a quality animal. And I think 3 miles, like, I'm not going to say 3 miles has been the key to him all along, but I think it's really interesting. Like the fact that look through his best races, he's always staying on. He's sort of showing that he stays rather than showing that it's electric speed that's winning him over 2 miles.
He is jocked up for the handicap on the last race on the card,
He's also jocked up for this as well. So, like, yeah. I'd be surprised if there's a handicap.
Would you not be worried, though? Would you not be worried the fact that this is just me playing devil's advocate here? They've tried it over the minimum trip. Now, are you worried that they're trying something new to try and eke out a result? Because to me, it looks like he's not good enough over the minimum trip against the top class athletes. Now they're just going to try it over a new trip. That's just looking at it from the outside point of view because I can't see it.
Well, they're trying something new, and that wouldn't worry me. Like, I agree with the fact that they're trying something new because they're trying to eke out improvement, but that wouldn't worry me. Look, he's 10. He's not getting any younger here. We probably won't see him for maybe one more season, I'd say, and then he's gone. But the fact he's been running most of his races over 2 miles, the age-old thing is if you run 2 miles over the flat, you're more than likely to stay on further Think of Buzz for Nicky Henderson. That horse was winning 2 mile races on the flat or 1 mile four race on the flat. That horse was the ante-post favourite for the stayers last season. Like, I really think it's quite interesting if he goes over 3 miles. Like, I've rambled here too much about the long walk. Not so sleepy for me. A 14-1, I'd be seriously, seriously interested in him. I think he'd rather go here than the handicap. I'll pass it over to Lee. I know you have some ante-post sort of fancies. We're going to look at some races outside of long walk. Just go through what you fancy at this early stage for the weekend if it goes ahead.
I was going to tip and Sam up. Was 8-1. It's been backed into 7-2. Won the race off a pound lower, off 1-3-4. Last season, 6 in the Coral Gold Cup, was hampered, but I thought it was a good enough run because I think he prefers to go this way around. Likes the course, so and Sam, but it's a bit short now. Picard obviously is a standout one. Beat Napa's Hill first time out. Second in Napa's Hill. Fell in a Supreme Trail behind. Mm. I like to move it behind John Bond and stuff like that last season. Absolutely bolted up first time out. Beat Hullen back and Master Chewy, who I think should have won at the weekend there in Cheltenham. So has strong form, but the market hasn't missed that one. I think Monviel of Philip Hobbs, I think that one's maybe overpriced, up £10, but absolutely bolted up the last day off 10. It's off 10 stone this time. Bolted up the last day. It's up to 130, but won by 8.5 lengths. There were some good horses in that race. I know the likes of WizKid and stuff who you like was in behind. So the Hobbs horse, but that Picard obviously hasn't been missed. And one on Navin on Sunday. It's the grade two over 2.5. Three card brag. I love this horse. Previously had beaten Sandor Clegane. So that horse obviously come out and bolted it up last week. Beat that horse by 6.5 length. Once a bit of juice in the ground. That's 12:30 at Navin on Sunday. So it's just one to watch out for. And I think there's one more. I take a chance maybe on Omar Moretti in the Tommy Whittle. That's 2:48. He got heard up if that one runs. It's £4 higher than its last mark from two runs back, but fairly bolted up that day. And then went to the Kim Muir, just run no sort of race, didn't jump well enough. But Omar Moretti, I think, is about 25s for the Tommy Whittle as well.
Thank you very much, Lee. Some interesting horses to watch out for there. Harry, we have got Christmas ante-post sort of fancies to look at, and make sure to stick on for the rest of the video to look at them. But what do you want to mention the weekend, that if it goes ahead?
There was one, Ash. We were actually at Newbury on Coral Gold Cup Day for this race. It is the, I want to say, I can't think of what the handicap's called. It's the Exchange Trophy, silly me. It's Petit Tonnerre for the John Joe O'Neill team. And we were there. We spoke to John Joe after the race. Now, this horse is only a four-year-old, and I really fancied this horse for the juvenile hurdle, the grade one, in April. Now, things didn't go right. It was, I mean, the horse made a couple of mistakes, pushed along a few flights out, and then just pulled up. John Joe did the right thing, pulled the horse up. Now, the last two runs, both at Aintree in October and Newbury in November, have been really good runs. Arguably bumped into one, Paul Nichols, with Red Risk, at a massive price, 20-1. I know, obviously, you napped up Dorking Boy, who was in third that day. Now, I just think this horse is only off 1-4-1. He's off 1-3-8 in October, so he's technically only gone up £3 since October. And I think this horse is still weighted well. I think this horse is a really smart horse, and he's only four, remember. So, listen, a big price here at 18-1. You could quite easily see this horse run another nice race, especially when you're going to get extra places on the day. So for me at the minute, Petit Tonnerre for John Joe O'Neill. Fingers crossed, it could be the JP McManus double. Champ and Petit Tonnerre.
I like this horse.
Was just going to mention, I was just going to mention one more race actually at the weekend there. The 3:30 at Navin on Sunday, there's a listed bumper. There's 8 declared, 4 of them for Gordon Elliott. So his chosen one is obviously going to be a strong interest. But King of Kingsfield is in there. Better Days Ahead. There's some strong horses running there. But there's an interesting one. Mm. Special Cadeau was with Pam Sly. Won a, I think it was a junior bumper. But now with Willie Mullins and for Clipper Logistics. So it's an interesting race to watch. That King of Kingsfield is... strong in the market for the champion bumper. So, but just interesting. Gordon's got four entered, and Willie only has the one choice there. So, want to keep an eye on.
Yeah, there's definitely a horse a lot of people like. And it's fair to say that in that exchange trophy on the weekend, the Twitter horse is Picard, and that's by far. Yeah. There's tons and tons and tons of people are on this horse. And I remember putting him up for Newbury the last day, and he was a non-runner. I've completely missed the boat with him, so I can't be going in the weekend.
Was he at the start of the week?
Yeah, he was something stupid. I think someone's got 12s. I think I know someone's got 12s this race, and it's now 7-2. There's two in here that I like. It's sort of each way price is definitely to back. The first would be Highway 102. Back this horse at Ascot when it won last time. I basically just think it's still well handicapped. Like that, you go through it. So there's Galore Desessence. I'm going to go with that one. That was given £12 for its win last time. And a horse called Mondial was given £10 for winning worse races than what Highway 102 won last time. This horse was given £8 for absolutely blitzing any Harman Askin, Hacker de Place at Washington and Call of the Wind. He wasn't stopping. £8 that day wouldn't have stopped him. I think he's really well handicapped still. So 8-1, have to give him a shout. But the main one, and I'm going back to a form line, gentlemen, that we rinsed time and time and time again last season. I'm going back. Think all the way 2021. Back in the glory days, it's the Greatwood Hurdle. What finished third that day? No Ordinary Joe. He's a lightly raced 6-year-old.
How are we still going on about this race?
Because he's going to win. He's a lightly raced 6-year-old. The form in the book is crazy. So on debut, he beat the £325,000 Fleming's Tide for Paul Nichols in a bumper at Sandown. Then went to the Grade 2 Supreme Trial at Ascot 2 years ago. Was fourth to My Drogo behind Landinibo Lad and Soaring Glory. So three very, very nice horses there. Beat Sounds Russian the time after that. That's now a 157 rated chaser. That was in a novice hurdle, I believe, over 2 mile 4. So he can stay that distance. So if it's the stiff test of Ascot on the weekend, he shows he's got a little bit of staying power to him. He continued on to win at Worcester the next time. And then he went into the Greatwood. I believe he was a bit backed on the day as well. He went off 8-1. I think I met a backed him at 16s on the day. He tried to make all. He was third to the extremely well-handicapped West Cork. And Adagio was in second. He was a very, very nice horse. He had Tritonic, Glory and Fortune, Marie's Rog, Botox Huss, and Strawfan Jack all in behind him, out with the washing. He was pulled up on the next time in this race last time. Last season, when well fancied by connections. He was actually in the mix two out, but just like pulled up straight away, jumped it. Nico just pulled him up. He just wasn't going right that day. So you can put the fastest line through that race. And I was going through it. I just sort of kept smiling and looking at sort of everything this horse had. It sort of really fit my bill of a horse to back, and he's 12-1. He can do it on good ground if it turns up like that. So if the race goes ahead on the weekend, I'll firmly be in the No Ordinary Joe camp. That is for sure. As long as, do we have anything else to mention, lads, or shall I move on?
We'll move on.
Move on, fantastic. We are going to cover some of the Christmas races because we won't have much racing on the weekend. We're going to all put up one horse for Christmas. We did this on the Saturday Live, and we put one up for the Cheltenham Festival. Unfortunately for Harry, he put Insta up, so you can say goodbye to that docket, eh, Harry?
Don't say hello to her. Do say hello to her, because I think she's still good. Remember, she's only four.
No, it's she's just a nice horse, but we did that for the Cheltenham Festival, and we're going to do it for Christmas. So I'll go over to you, Harry. Redeem yourself. What race are you going to be putting up for? I think we know, but what's the horse that you're going to be putting up for at Christmas time?
No, it wouldn't be me without tipping up an old boy for one of the biggest races at Chepstow. It's in the Welsh Grand National. It's the old boy, the 9-year-old, Lord de Menil. Now, I love this horse.
You say old, and we said this off camera. You mentioned him. You mentioned him, and I thought, Jesus, he must be 16. He's 9. That's completely fine.
He feels like an old boy because he's just been around, but he's not. As Ash mentioned, he is only a 9-year-old. Now, his form line last time out is now reading really, really nicely. He was only a few lengths behind the now Coral Gold Cup winner, Lamilos, on his reappearance run at Bangor, and he wasn't given any sort of winning chance at all, which is completely understandable for his first run back. It was a really promising run. He was dropped out right at the back, And I read the trainer's comments after he was told, the jockey was basically told, don't be too hard on him. Give him a nice reappearance at him. We'll go for the Welsh National. Now, if this is the plan, I think this horse could go really well. I think 16-1 now. I backed at 16-1. And it takes a solid horse to win a race like this. Now, you need to stay and you need to have a decent amount of talent. This horse is riddled with stamina and he's riddled with talent in my eyes. He's been there, he's done it. Even though he is a 9-year-old, he's been there on the biggest days and he's performed. It does go well in December time, which is also it's always a plus for me. So I think if the ground turns up, it's a little bit soft. Obviously, we've seen this frosty ground. It might be a little bit tacky towards the end. This horse will relish it. And if he goes from the front, he could be a massive player. So 16-1, Lord de Mesnil for the Welsh Grand National.
16-1. Love that, Harry, for the Welsh Grand National Handicap Race. Lee, you've got one from the Irish races, one of the grade ones. So do tell what horse you fancy.
It's no 16-1. I think it's about 7-4 max. But
Merry Christmas, everybody.
I'm going for
get
a horse,
feed that turkey.
In a race. Look, I don't want no silly handicap like yours, Harry. I want a winner, you know what I mean? I want that money in the bag. Look, Jerry Coulomb, I think the race will just suit the horse down to the ground. It's the Fohin Novice Chase, 26th of December. St. Stephen's Day, as the Irish call it. It's Boxing Day. It's a grade one, 2 miles, 3.5 furlongs, but it's always soft ground, soft to heavy. That'll suit this lad down to the ground. Won last time, beat Bron, who's back in the race as well. But Bron is a grade two winner. There's Chantreuse in there behind. That was a grade three winner last season. Coccolino, there was even Freedom to Dream, who was fourth in the Martin Pike behind Banbridge. And even Sam's Profile beating 22 lengths the last day there. That was a Galmoy hurdle winner. So I just think this race will just suit it down the ground. I've penciled this race in for the horse at the start of the season just because conditions will be absolutely right up his street. So Jerry Coulomb, I know it's short, but the likes of Appreciate It hasn't even had a chase run yet. There's Classic Getaway, Mighty Potter, I doubt he'll go. Banbridge won't like conditions. There's a lot in there that won't go. So Gerhard hasn't been out yet. We haven't even seen him. So look, the race will cut up. There's normally about 4 or 5 runners. Soft to heavy ground, absolutely spot on. So Jerry Coulomb for a definite winner over Harry's 16-1 rag in a Welsh National.
Well, you did mention, I mean, it's 16-1. Obviously, it is a big price difference. But, I mean, as you mentioned, this race is going to cut up, isn't it, really? I mean, you've got the likes of Kilcrook, Classic Getaway, Marty Potter. 6-4 now for a horse who was so impressive on Chase debuted. I mean, yeah, that could soon be gone, couldn't it?
It's just because, honestly, at the start of the season, I wanted to pencil this one in as a race that would suit this horse. It needs these conditions. Gordon Elliott said a few weeks back that the festivals will be fine because they're running good to soft. They're not going to be rattling quick ground. He does need juice in the ground, but to beat a grade two winner, grade three winner, a Galnoy hurdle winner, first time up, went well at the lane. I do think he wants to step up and trip. I did back him for the Brown advisory, and I really take him with the horse. There's a couple of interesting ones, actually. James de Burley, I think Ash really likes that horse, and Journey with Me is in there as well. So them two to keep an eye on. But the likes of Three Stripe Life, obviously he unseated. He was pulled up the last day. He may take his chance, but the likes of Mighty Potter and Banbridge definitely won't go here. So Jerry Coulomb, I just think he's a solid horse for that race for sure.
He is. Now look at this. And for those that are watching this right now, wouldn't have understood what has just cracked off, because if you'd have been asking why Ash has secretly disappeared, it's not because he doesn't like us. It's because he made the rookie error of not charging his phone. So in the professional manner that me and Lee conducted ourselves in, we conducted it in that no one else would know. That no one else would know that you'd gone, Ash. So,
but now they know.
Ash, now they know. How are you? Ash, how are you? Welcome to the show.
Yeah, no, phone died. Yeah, I have no excuse. Podcast Ash, host.
If don't take him burgling with you, he'll squeal like a pig.
Podcast. I'm host. I'm just unprepared as anything, but I believe Jerry Cologne was your pick, Lee. Was it the favourite by any chance?
No, he's 33.
You can't say anything, Ash, now that your phone's died, mate. So you best come out with a good anti-post prick here. So.
Well, you know what? Mine's just a solid horse that will definitely suit the race and go to the race, do you know what I mean? So yeah. I know it's short, but it's just a horse I like going forward as well.
Definitely. And Harry, you're going to love this. I'm kind of copping out because if you listened into the Cheltenham Festival sort of look that we did at the weekend, I talked about a horse called James's Gate for Willie Mullins. And I went through the Christmas races. I couldn't find anything that was that solid. I liked one in the Savills, Conflated. I think that kind of just wins, to be honest, 9-2. But I thought I wanted to find one that, at a bigger price. And I landed on James de Burley. Look, I could go through the whole reasoning why I like this horse, why I think he could be a really nice horse in the novice company. His French form works out really well. A horse called Moises Haas. If you're comparing his rating to what James de Burley would be rated equivalent, he's rated somewhere in the 160, which is really nice. And he should be going better over 3 miles. If you want a full in depth on that, I will link on the screen. I'll link in the description where to go to find out my full description on this horse, because it's about 10 minutes long and it's really thorough, but I don't have the notes to hand to me right now. I will talk about this horse though for Christmas, because we haven't seen him since April 2021. Slight issue, I'd say. He's entered for 3 races at the Cheltenham Festival. He's entered for all 3 novice chases, the Arkle, Brad Advisory and the Turners. He's entered for 2 races at Christmas, the 14 novice chase and the Leopardstown Neville Hotels novice chase over 3 miles. 14's obviously 2.5. The inner heart in me would love to see him over 3 miles. How he stayed on behind Classical Dream when he was last seen in that grade one at Punchestown, now I want to say, was really nice. Came from an unwinnable position and he did well. So I'd love to see him in the 3 mile Neville, but we might see him over 2 mile, 3.5.
I was just going to say, because you know what? Forgive us if I'm wrong, but I'm sure Willie Mullen said before, because he ran in the champion hurdle, didn't he? And yeah. I'm sure he says, oh, he's our Arkle horse at the time. And then, look, they do it with like Kilcroot and different stuff. We are clearly seeing different things from what they see sometimes, but like, he definitely wants to step up and trip memories. But
He's already sort of done it over 3 miles in my eyes. Like that run behind Classical Dream was really good because he came from absolutely nowhere. He just stayed on really, really well. And the form book reads 9 lengths behind, but the way he was sort of actually sort of like gaining on Classical Dream, he wasn't losing any lengths. I'd love to see him in the Neville Hotels, but we'll probably see him in the 14 novice chase just to sort of like start his season off in a lower grade.
Come second to Jerry Cologne, yeah?
We can have the 1-2. I'll take that. That's fine. But yeah, as Willie Mullins likes to do, he starts them off in sort of an easier contest, smaller distance, to then go into their thing. We're going to see that probably gallop into Shumps and the John Durkin. So yeah, it'll be James de Burley for me, 16-1 for the 14, 20-1 for the Neville Hotels. Either one, take your pick. I'll be having a bit of them. That's all we got to cover. Have we got any competitions to plug, Lee? We got a competition for an umbrella, I believe.
Yes, we have a Lom Press umbrella. Obviously, the horse may be going to the King George, but he's definitely a Gold Cup contender. And you will need that umbrella out there. This conditions are not good. So, no, enter the competition. It's on our page, Only Fools Love Horses. We'll also have a great guest who will keep under our hat for our Christmas special. And we'll be doing some different stuff around Christmas. But for our live on Christmas Eve, we'll go through the Boxing Day races and stuff like that, but we'll not reveal who we've got yet.
Hot property we've got for now. I can't wait. No, thank you very much for watching on the YouTube channel. We are available on Spotify as well. Just type in Only Fools Love Horse and you should find it there. If you're having trouble typing it on Spotify, just go into our Twitter and there's a link back from maybe 5 or 6 posts back on Only Fools Love Horses Racing on Twitter. Click on that link over there and you'll find our page. This will be up on Spotify in the next couple hours, if not latest Wednesday morning. It'll be up on Spotify. If you did enjoy, please do like and subscribe and follow all of us on the screen. I'm going to hide this here. Oh, my Twitter username isn't even there. I've done myself there. It's just Ash. You got the Twitter usernames for them. It's just Ash at the bottom. Do follow us on Twitter at AceAndJoe, at RacingMe1, at HarryBeard7. And if you did enjoy, please like and subscribe. We'll be back 10:30 a.m. Saturday morning for the Saturday Live. If it goes ahead, we might be doing another ante-post one. Who knows at this stage? Do stay safe out there if it keeps with this cold weather and snow, and have an enjoyable week.
Thank you, everybody.